aortic stenosis is a slow, progressive degeneration of the aortic valve that happens most commonly because of age. People with aortic stenosis know they have a problem by one of a few different symptoms. Most common is probably shortness of breath. As the disease progresses and the valve gets narrower and narrower, their activity level is more and more limited. Some people get chest pain, not because they necessarily have blockage in their coronary arteries, but the pressure on the opposite side of that narrowed valve becomes so great that the wall stress on the heart becomes greater and greater. Some people get lightheaded or dizzy or even frankly pass out. If you can't get blood flow through that valve, you can't supply blood to the brain. The fourth one is potential for some fatal heart rhythms that occur.
The heart is quite literally pounding against an exit door, if you will, that won't swing all the way open, and that's the aortic valve. CoreValve allows that exit door to be opened appropriately and to also close appropriately. There is no medication that can substitute for that level of mechanical intervention.
The primary benefit for patients receiving a CoreValve versus a traditional open heart surgery is their early recovery. Most of the CoreValve patients by 30 days are just doing great. You know, we're blessed in this hospital to have the access to a CoreValve and to have the best valve surgeons in the country.
The main thing is that people aren't feeling well. They've got shortness of breath. They're getting hospitalized for fluid in their lungs. They're just not happy with their quality of life. So they want to feel better. And so our job is to tell them, how can we make you feel better with the minimum amount of risk? And that's what we want to commit to them. So when they come to talk to us, we want to commit that we're on your side to make you feel better with the least amount of risk.
And then rather than schedule a procedure, we'll have the patient see one of our colleagues to see what they think, to get their opinion. Oftentimes we'll share electronic images and talk the patient over. And then once we make a plan, we'll execute that plan together. We share similar values, so it's easy to work on such an enjoyable team. There's a lot of talent at El Camino Hospital, and it's all professionally focused. Our only interest besides actual patient care is patient-related research.
El Camino's really had a pivotal role in the CoreValve trials. We were fortunate to be amongst the first 10 centers in the country selected to participate. The first day that the trial was approved, we were amongst the first two centers in the country to get going with this important technology. And we've been very active in the development and contribution to the research that has led to the commercial approval of the device. We've taken a leading role and tried to offer something to this community that otherwise they might not have access to.
So it's a community hospital that does really the most advanced, most cutting edge procedures, but in a community hospital setting.
We work in an absolutely beautiful facility that is right up to date and has all the things that we need to make it easy to work in. And we have incredibly good staff, nursing, and right through the entire staff of the hospital, just people willing to help. So there's a culture of excellence here.
This is something that I think we're proud of and that we're trying to do as well as we can. One of the things that makes it exciting is there isn't a lot of precedent for it. So we're literally creating something with the patients and for the patients.
We've really come to understand the device, the patients to offer it to, how to deal with them. We continue to look at our processes and ways that we can improve it. We're in this game to stay. I think we're in a good lead position. We're looking at new generations of valves, new opportunities. It's only going to get better.